Welcome to Top to Bottom Male Male Romance Podcast, where we celebrate all things male male romance. I am Jessica.
And I'm Markie.
And this is our Happy New Year, January top episode for 2019.
Yes, Happy New Year's, everybody.
Yeah.
I guess as a quick, before we dive into the normal intro and stuff, I'm sure you all are aware by now, but we hit publish on our episode that was actually supposed to go up New Year's Eve. It went live a little sooner, so happy New Year's Eve bonus for everybody. That was fantastic and awesome. It was actually kind of great because when we realized it went up a little early, we went to go try to fix it and realized it had already been downloaded a handful of times. And I was like, oh, cool. That means people actually have us on like auto download. So that was kind of fun. So pretty kick-ass way to start 2019 is being like, yay, we have people who listen to us on a consistent basis.
Yes, thank you for doing so. We love you.
Yes, absolutely. So back to the normally scheduled program. Before we get into all the fun stuff that we're going to talk about this episode, we do want to remind you that we do have reader groups. We have a group on Facebook and Goodreads. You can jump in and talk to us about our bottom picks every month, recommend cool series that for us to pick up and read, talk to us about cool movies you found, comic book series you fell in love with, anything related to MM romance, you can jump in and let us know. We also have a Patreon. Our patrons get inside information about who we might be interviewing and have an option to submit questions to that person. So if you haven't had a chance to go check us out, make sure you do so.
Yep. And as always, if you have not yet rated us on whatever it is you listen to us on, please go and do so. It helps other people find us that are interested in the same stuff we are.
Indeed. So I'm very excited about our book pick for the month of January because I have been a fan of this person for a very long time. So for January, we are reading Dominus by the magical JP Kenwood. And one of the main reasons we are picking this series is because the third installment of this series comes out at the end of January. So since we have to get all ready for book number three, we figured we'd make everybody join in as we read through the first book again.
I'm really super excited about this. You made me excited to read this book ages ago, and I picked it up at really, really bad timing because we had an onslaught of books we had to do for podcast and for some other stuff outside of podcast world. So I got cut short. Like, I was only a couple of chapters in and I got pulled away from it, which really bummed me out because I didn't super realize what the premise was and how it was set up. And this isn't really super spoiler because this is how the book opens up, but I did not realize the magical way in which she starts this book. It starts like present day-ish with an archaeologist doing a dig, and he finds stuff that makes it seem like it's going to tie into the main story. So it starts present day, and then it zaps back to this Rome flashback, and with really, really fun characters that are great. So yeah, I'm really, really excited because now I can carve out the time because it is the podcast thing, and yeah, I'm super stoked for this.
Yeah, her stories are really fantastic, very character centric. But JP is a huge Rome buff. Like I think she studies Rome, like historical Rome, in her day job, but we'll touch back on that. But all of the stuff that's in the main story is very historically accurate, like what they talk about and the way that their nicknames are done and the way that the society's laid out and relationships with people. It's freaking great. I remember reading through it and I actually put the book down in like Wikipedia things to see if I was like, oh, really? That's fascinating. I want to know more about it. Since it's set back into ancient Rome, it really lends itself to a lot of ridiculous espionage and cool plot threads, and the sexiness that's in it is just, oh, it's mouthwatering and debaucherous, and I love it. So I'm very excited to read through book one again, and I'm going to have to eat book two very quickly so I could dive into book three because I've been highly anticipating this release for quite some time. I'm very excited.
I'm really excited. I'm a super history nerd, and we don't read a lot of historical fiction.
Man, historical romance does not get enough love. That is, I'm a big fan of it. And it's one of those genres that I think a lot of people are understandably apprehensive to jump onto because it's hard to do well. You know what I mean? Like it's hard to write something that you can relate to if it's set back at a time far, far away. And the vernacular is usually very different. And so, you know, authors are stuck in this weird situation. Do they write it true to how they would really talk back in the ye old days or back in historical Rome? Or would they write it with something more familiar with the way people talk now. And then, of course, you've got your almost cringeworthy freak out of, you know, if these people get caught, because depending on what time period you're reading, if they get caught in the, you know, gay romance that they're in, they could be, their whole lives would be ruined most of the time. So it's, I remember somebody had posted in a book group recently about how they can't get into historical romance because of that, because the whole time they're reading it, especially with like Regency and stuff like that, they're like, oh my God, like, what if somebody walks in right now? You know, like their whole lives are shit. So it's totally understandable. So I'm pretty stoked.
To be fair, if you want to talk about Regency romance in general, if anybody walks in right now, even if you're talking het romance, those women of society, if they would have been caught doing their naughty things, that they would have been ruined. So, I mean, that's not just something that's specific to male. That's just a romance thing in general. But the outfits are fantastic.
You got me there.
So speaking of that, I think that's a good segue to our fresh banana.
Yeah. So our fresh banana that we have for January is, so they're new as of November last year. So they're just ripe, I guess. But it's a Regency romance, and the premise of it sounded fantastic. Basically, a penniless nobleman and writer of sensational serials discovers that his story has been stolen, and so he takes it upon himself to confront the person who he believes is responsible, who is a very well-to-do editor. So, of course, it spirals into shenanigans at that point. Part of the blurb says, James takes his masquerade too far, behaving nothing at all like a gentleman. And the book is actually called Like a Gentleman by Elliot Grayson. It looks really cool. And it's a Regency romance, so always fun and fabulous and gets your blood pumping because who knows what's going to happen. So definitely worth checking out. It's on Amazon. I want to say Kindle Unlimited, and it's only a couple bucks if you guys wanted to snatch it. But Elliot Grayson is also part of the New Year, New Author giveaway that took place earlier in the month. So you probably already have a short story of theirs downloaded. So there's a fun little nugget for you.
So yeah, we have historical romance January. That's a happy accident. Did we plan that? I don't think we planned that.
Of course we planned that. We totally have our shit together.
Totally have our shit together.
So do you want to chat about New Year's resolution stuff?
Yeah. So we, in our bottom episode for December, talked about how we did for our 2018 New Year's resolutions. And we did pretty well. Neither one of us completely crossed off everything from our list, but we made valiant efforts and got a lot of it done. So yay us.
Mm-hmm.
So now we will lay out. So what we're going to do is we're going to talk about our book related resolutions, some personal ones, because if you listen to us, it's probably because you just adore us as people. And then some actual podcast related goals and resolutions for top to bottom.
Yeah. So I guess let me flip it and start with you, since we started with me last time. So Jess, what are your personal goals for 2019?
Oh. Ha-ha. Yeah, so this is the one I'm having a bit of a hard time with, because I have some things, but much like I just seconds ago assumed you guys would care to hear, I also assume you don't care at all. So this is why I don't post on social media, is because I think originally that I'll share stuff, and then I'm like, oh, but nobody's gonna care. What, why am I wasting people's time? But you know, whatever, it's my podcast, so I guess y'all can listen to me.
Well, I care and I want to know.
So that whole writing thing I didn't do last year, I would like to take another stab at that. I have kind of a precious project that I've been stewing on for quite a while, but it seems too big to jump in on. But I'd like to make some progress on that as far as structuring. That's not very unlikely to be a male-male romance, but it's just too dear to ignore. But I'd like to at least do some short stories. But you and I have some collaboration ideas for me to work with Maz and actually be writing instead of just editing. So I'd like to see some of that come to fruition. Aside from that, personally, I like to cook a whole lot and bake and things like that. And I've recently been bitten by this bug of wanting to like make a fancy cake, like make a really, really pretty, like Instagram worthy cake. So we'll see how that goes. And then I want to learn how to cook something new, and I don't really know what yet, but like I want to just outside of my normal comfort zone, like cook something weird and see how that goes. So yeah. And then I've got like all the normal personal, you know, health and appearance crap that, you know, won't go into detail, but all of that's there as well. And I'll still be able to tell you if that went well at the end of the year. But personally, that's really about it. It's not anything super exciting or new, but at least for as far as resolutions are concerned, it's kind of run-of-the-mill kind of stuff. But, you know,
well,
there you go.
I'm excited about the writing part of it. Like, I cannot wait to collaborate and come up with something fantastic with you. So I'm like, yee!
So, what about you?
Are we doing personal ones first and then...
Oh, yeah. Bitch, I'm turning this back on you.
Oh, okay. Fine. I think all of my personal ones that I have are all writing related, which is kind of lame because I was thinking, oh, you know, I should really get back into yoga or buy a treadmill or something. I'm like, okay, sure. But are you going to do those? No. So I put all of my actual energy into thinking about what I wanted to do writing wise. So that'd be MAS. For 2019, for MAS, I want to go to at least one signing event. Either, hopefully, fingers crossed, GRL as an author, which would be fucking cool, or some type of other local signing event or something. Somehow get somewhere where I'm signing books is what I want. So that's one of them. The second one is do a collaboration. and then write 3 books for MAS, 3 full-length books, either within the series that I'm currently writing or at least maybe one as a different series. I don't know, but it has to be 3 full novel sized books within 2019, which I'm pretty confident I'll hit. So maybe I can up that goal as the year progresses, but 3 is baseline for that.
Nice.
Yeah. So what about book related stuff? What's your 2019 book goals?
Okay. I have a few authors on the top of my head that I know I want to get to, even though I know I'm not like, I can only think of 2 off the top of my head, and I should have written down more because I know that there's a hell of a lot more that I haven't read yet. But 2 of the ones I want to get to this year that I have not read at all is Haley Turner and Nicholas Bella.
Nice.
Yeah, and I have another book goal, and it's kind of shitty. I want to find an author that is amazing that you haven't read yet and make you read them.
Hey, man, challenge accepted. I want you to find somebody that I haven't at least seen in passing because... boy, am I like immersed in this shit. So if you could find
Now you're making it difficult. I'm not talking about ones that you haven't seen in passing because you are seriously tits deep in all of the, the entire genre. And I am not. So I'm talking about somebody you haven't read yet.
Okay.
Which actually, I guess I did that with TJ Klune. I read TJ before you did, but I don't know that I can count that. So anyways, this is a new year and I want to read somebody awesome and freak out about them before you do.
Okay. That's totally fair.
And I don't really know where this fits in, but this is kind of personal book and podcast related. All 3 is GRL. Like that is absolutely the plan, but I also know how life goes. So I'm saying there's like a 95% absolution that I'm going.
Yeah.
You know, but you know, there's money and other things to consider for that. Do we have the date for that, by the way? Because I really hope it's not that last weekend of October.
Yes. Question mark. It's not the last weekend of October. I think it's going to be like it was this year. No. Last year, 2018, it's going to be December, like 20th, December. My God. October
17th through the 20th.
Yes.
In Albuquerque, Mexico.
Yes. 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 There it is. You got it. Nailed it. and I think it's usually about the same time period every year. So, which is nice. But yeah, that's one of my goals too. I don't know why I didn't write that. Well, I said GRL, didn't I? So yeah, I'm back. I'm here.
Sure you are.
Yeah.
Anyways. So yes. That too. But yeah, I'm going to, Coronite. Coronite's another one that I know that was on my list of authors I have not yet read that I would definitely want to read this year. God, I know there's so many more. I can't believe my brain's blanking.
Dude, it's really a safe bet to put like 3 or 4 on there because we do have so many that we love and have been on our to-read list forever. So I don't want to put myself in another situation like I did last year where I've got, I miss a couple and then I feel like an asshole at the end of the year because I didn't get to them. So,
okay, well then I'll make that my thing. Haley Turner, Nicholas Bella, and Cora Knight are the 3 authors I want to try to get to this year.
Nice.
So stated will happen. Your turn.
So fun fact, Haley Turner's also one of mine. So I feel pretty safe that that one's going to get crossed off. I'm dragging E.A. Villa back over since I missed her completely. So E.A. Villa, Haley Turner, and Nora Phoenix are my 3 that I will read in 2019.
Nice.
Yes.
Okay. Any other reading goals in general? You want to keep it simple because that's safe.
Keeping it simple is probably the way to go, because I wanted to say like, oh, I want to make sure I read this trope or this genre. Like, I want to read X amount of Regency or something. And I'm like, yeah, no, I don't want to nail that down in case I can't. I want to make sure. Yeah, I want to make sure I can hit the like some new authors I haven't read yet and just go with that.
But, you know, that's the point of a resolution, is to strive and try to, you know, do something more than you normally would have done, make it a point, make it a goal. So you're playing it safe, Missy.
Yeah, well, tough.
Just, you don't say. Yeah.
Insert witty comeback here. I don't know, man.
All right. So you had this great idea of making top to bottom resolutions,
yeah,
podcast resolutions for us to achieve as podcasters.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I wanted to try to do a couple different things for the podcast in 2019. And this kind of spurred from when we did our birthday giveaway. The person who ended up actually winning the contest, her post talking about her favorite episode was the one that we did with Yamelia about the To Trust an Incubus game. And she was like, I would really like to see more things beyond just MM romance novels. I really liked it when you guys branched out into different things. And I was like, I mean, that was already the goal. That's why our podcast is all things male-male romance. We want to try to hit all different medias, but it's easier for us to pick up a book and read than some of the other things that we wanted to try to do. So one of the goals that I had in mind was us trying to do like streaming a game, like maybe streaming To Trust an Incubus or doing like a Twitch thing or something like that. I think that'd be super fun if we could play some male-male romance games or dating sims or something and maybe trying to do something like that with the podcast. So
how do we link that to the podcast?
I mean, if we got like a Twitch channel and called it Top to Bottom or something, we could probably do it. I know a lot of people do, like YouTubers will do reviews. So maybe if we don't stream it, we could record it and then upload it on YouTube of us like being jackasses and playing this game. So I don't know. It's also a question of if we have the tech and can figure out how to do it. I feel like it's probably not as hard as we think, but it's one of those like pinned resolutions. I really want us to do it, but if it doesn't happen, then it's going to be more of a like, our computers suck, or we couldn't figure out how to do this the way we wanted to, because a lot of the games that we want to play have, you know, nudity in them. Although I know that To Trust an Incubus on Steam is censored, so we could probably get away with that.
And she has those super cute chibi censors.
Yeah, yeah. So if we do play it, I mean, we have to play that one if we're going to broadcast it anywhere, which is just an extra bonus because that's awesome. We could probably do that. So that I'm really hoping we can try to finagle that. So that's one of the goals. And then
you talked about like graphic novels or comic books?
Yes. I want one of the months that we have is instead of doing a novel, do a manga or a comic book as one of our bottom picks, which I think would be kind of cool because we haven't done that. We've talked about comic books, but we haven't made that a monthly pick. And I thought that'd be kind of cool. I don't know, because with comics and manga and everything, it's a full series. So we couldn't do just like one comic. Right? I mean, we wouldn't be able to do just like issue one of something because it's really small. That's the other thing I'm trying to figure out. How would we do that?
Well, I mean, I know that a lot of times once several issues come out, they'll do like a compendium
mm-hmm.
of some stuff. So we'll fish around, see what we can find. And other option is maybe we find like the first issue of like two or three things and
ooh, that's a good idea.
And just kind of make a month of it. So if you guys have opinions, listeners, we are all ears.
Yeah, I would absolutely love to get people's recommendations of comic books or manga or something that is like your top favorite things. And then maybe we can pick up a couple of those and maybe do, like you said, do like three different ones and pick up the first one or two and kind of get a taste of what the characters are like and the plot and everything. Because I doubt we'll be able to read a full series because comic books usually last, I don't know, hundreds of issues depending on what it is. Or they have seasons. Like I know Fence, the first season is done and that was 12 issues. So I'm not going to subject you to reading 12 issues of a comic book, even though it's great and you should.
It's not that long though, is it?
It's not that long. And if they do like a collection, like if they come out with volume one with all of them in there as a graphic novel, which I think they're supposed to, that would be perfect. But I also don't know when that comes out. So
there's also, I am super not in the world of comics very much, but I'm super lame. I have a hard time reading them because when I'm reading regular books, I get such vivid pictures and stuff in my head, and reading a comic, it's like they're putting that picture on there for me. And then like the way panels work, I have a hard time following exactly where they're supposed to go. But there's this app called Comixology that you go panel to panel and you just swipe and it takes you to the next panel you're supposed to see, which really helps me a lot. I don't know if we'd be able to find anything like that on Comixology, or I've always just used it on my husband. So I don't know if it's like a subscription thing or how it works, or how you have to pay for it. But I know you can get comics and stuff like that on Kindle as well. So
yeah, you can. I think Fence, when you read it on Kindle, it's like that. Like you can make it to where it's one panel at a time. Because I want to say I read the first two or three on my Kindle, and that's how I was reading it, and it was really cool.
Okay, so we'll look into that and see the best way. And again, any listener suggestions, we are more than happy to listen to and look into to kind of help us broaden our horizons there, because this podcast is for you guys. So what you guys want to see, share, whatever, just let us know and we're going to try to work it into what we do.
Absolutely. And then I think the last resolution I had, which kind of fits with one of the authors you want to try to read, is I want us to pick a cool sci-fi book pick at some point in 2019. Have we done a straight up sci-fi book yet? I don't think we have, right?
I'm pretty confident we haven't.
Yeah.
I know friend of the podcast, Ms. Carriger, has her, I think it's called The Fifth Gender, coming out sometime this year. Mm-hmm. I think she said May, but I could be making that up. It's going to be real difficult to not make that a pick. I know we've had her on a couple of times, but, and then of course, yeah, you said Cora does sci-fi.
Yeah. Well, so the first in her super sexy alien series is is totally doable. The first one's like more of a novella. It's real short. The second one's like 600 pages and that one's a beast. So I feel like that one might be a little harder to make a book pick, because trying to read a big book like that within a month, for some people, it's kind of rough. So we'll see. But if anything, we can do the first one, because it is super naughty and the aliens are adorable and I love them. Like her profile picture is one of the main characters from her first book, whose name is Gesh. And I remember when she posted that, I hashtagged like Gesh's Bay. Like I freaking adore him. So yeah, we should read that.
Well, so noted.
Yes.
All right. So we have lots of things to do this year.
Mm-hmm. I think our goals are reasonable, not over the top and ridiculous. I think they're pretty fair. And I'm very confident we can hit, I want to say, all of these, especially with the podcast. We could totally do this shit.
I really just want to force you to have one slightly unreasonable resolution.
Oh, goodness. I'm trying to think. I was going to put, like, I wanted to visit another country or something. And I was like, okay, fucking money bags. How are you going to do that? Like, why would you say that? So, man, I don't know. I feel like the author signing is my, like, top tier ridiculous, because even if I can get there, I'm going to chicken shit out, man. I'm going to be hiding under tables and crying. Like, I can't imagine me actually doing this shit.
No, I'll be there with you. I'll fix it. It'll be okay. Also, to do author signings at GRL, don't you have to be there as an author?
You do. You have to either be a featured author or a, not featured, or as a, what am I trying to think of the word? Supporting. Supporting author. Supporting. Not even a hard word. So yeah, either featured or supporting. And there are different tiers and there's different things that go with them. Like if you're a supporting author, you're part of the big like Saturday signing. Yeah, if you're a featured author, you do that. And then the supporting author, I think, has like a smaller signing on Friday or something. And they change it every year, but it's kind of like that. And I think I'm going to shoot for supporting author.
Okay. Well, if I remember correctly, last year, the day that GRL registration went live, several authors were like, yay, I got in. And other people were like, oh, crap, I missed it. So you need to be on that.
Oh, I know. Like, yeah, it's one of those. If I'm going to do it, I've got to commit to it. Like, because when it goes live, they only have a certain amount of spots open. So you've got to jump on and register like right then. And it's got like a hard start time and it just fills up really fast. So I plan on when that's announced, like being ready to jump in and snag the spot that I want. So that's the plan.
Nice.
And then at that point, I'm locked into it. So hopefully I'll get my spot and they'll be like, yay. And then I'll call you crying and be like, what the fuck am I going to do? So yeah, it'll be great. Magic.
Okay. Well, all right. Anything else we want to talk about in this first episode of 2019?
No, other than I'm super stoked that we're still doing this podcast and that we've got our lovely listeners hanging out with us and hopefully also setting up their own 2019 goals, which we'd still love to hear about. So if you guys have some cool book related or life related stuff that you're going to try to accomplish in 2019, you should let us know because we'd love to hear about it.
I think I will make a post, but I'll have to wait until this episode goes live.
Indeed.
All right. Well, cool. I guess that is it for now. We will see you at the bottom of the month.
Yes.
Yeah. Until then.
We'll see you later.
Bye.